Some members of the Filipino Chinese business community also concerned over the potential impact of the Israel-Hamas conflict to the global economy. Meanwhile, the Federation of Filipino Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry said the country's export sector could still leverage the country's ties with China for growth. And Andrea Taguines has more.
The Federation of Filipino Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated is worried business confidence could again take a hit because of the Israel-Hamas war, similar to what happened when the conflict between Russia and Ukraine began. FFCCCII President Cecilio Pedro said the war may also push world oil prices up if the conflict escalates and if other Middle Eastern countries get involved.
The global economy is slowing down because of the war in Ukraine and Russia. And just a couple of days or 2 days ago, pumutok pa yung Israel and Palestinian war. That is going to hurt our world economy. Nawawala po yung confidence ng mga businessmen to go around to do business because of potential war. Let's say binomba nila yung Iran o yung Iraq, tatamaan yung oil. Di lalong tataas yung presyo natin sa oil. Pag tumaas ang presyo ng oil, patay. Lahat tayo, tataas ng presyo. Pati yung bigas, pati yung lahat. So that is a concern. Hopefully they will settle as soon as possible.
Despite growing geopolitical tensions, Pedro believes the Philippines remains attractive to investors, largely due to its young workforce. But he also stressed the need for the upskilling of Filipino workers, especially in the use of new technologies such as artificial intelligence.
They should come and explore and look at potential here in the Philippines, in spite of the war. But we should also look at other means to strengthen ourselves, di ba? Kailangan magkaroon tayo ng competitive edge. Ano po yung competitive edge natin? Ang mga Filipino workers. We should continue to develop our skills, especially on technology, AI.
Pedro also welcomed the Philippines' latest trade figures as the country's trade deficit narrowed to $4.13 billion in August. But he said there is still room for growth, adding that the Philippines should export more goods to China.
Maraming pwedeng i-export sa China dahil yung China, napakalaki yung market nila. We should take advantage dahil open pa sila sa atin. Kahit may problema tayo sa South China Sea, tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang negosyo.
The group earlier opposed proposals to stop trading with China amid the territorial disputes concerning the West Philippine Sea, saying such a move would be detrimental to the Philippine economy. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The deadly fighting between Israel and Hamas militants enters its fifth day. The combined death toll from the war approaching 2,000 as a humanitarian crisis quickly unfolds. We have more in this report.
Israelis living in the areas surrounding the Gaza Strip have been evacuated, and rockets continue to shoot out of the enclave. The more than 2 million Palestinian people inside are trapped, as it is pummeled by heavy weaponry day and night. Among the civilians in Gaza are as many as 150 Israeli hostages. Family members are terrified that their loved ones will not be rescued.
I don't know how it is going to end, but the end will not be a happy end for nobody. It's not a happy end for nobody.
Humanitarian groups inside Gaza say the crisis is deepening for civilians already cut off from the world and now cut off from outside resources like electricity, water, and food. In Jerusalem, about an hour and a half from Gaza and still close enough to sometimes take rocket fire, many Israelis are enraged by the conflict, saying despite their government's famed security prowess, it failed to protect them. Others in this market blame the Palestinian people as a whole, saying the two sides of this conflict have never been more at odds.
I say it again, or us or them. We can stop. We need to eat them and eat them strong.
Hamas, the militant group that launched the surprise attack on Saturday, rules in Gaza. Hundreds of civilians on both sides have been killed, and thousands have been injured. Outside the Gaza Strip, debris from the first days of this new war remains on the abandoned streets. as Israel mounts its forces for what may soon be even more of an escalation. VOA News reporting from Jerusalem, Kfar Daniel, and southern Israel.
Two Filipinos confirmed among the fatalities in the Israel-Hamas war. In a statement, Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo says Manila condemns the killing of its nationals and all other acts of terrorism as a result of Hamas's actions against Israel. It was not immediately clear if the two were among the six Israel-based Filipinos that have yet to be accounted for. Manalo gave no further details but says the DFA would continue to provide all possible assistance to distressed Filipinos in the region. There are some 30,000 Filipinos in Israel and 137 in the Gaza Strip. U.S. President Joe Biden reaffirms America's commitment to provide Israel with full support, calling the Hamas attack over the weekend an act of sheer evil. Biden says Washington is sending munitions and providing intelligence support and stands ready to take additional steps.
We're going to make sure that Israel does not run out of these critical assets to defend its cities and its citizens. My administration has consulted closely with Congress throughout this crisis. And when Congress returns, we're going to ask them to take urgent action to fund the national security requirements of our critical partners. This is not about party or politics. This is about the security of our world, the security of the United States of America. And let there be no doubt, the United States has Israel's back. We'll make sure the Jewish and democratic state of Israel can defend itself today, tomorrow, as we always have. It's as simple as that.
Some 14 Americans reportedly killed in the attack, while around 20 others are believed to be held hostage. The U.S. is encouraging Qatar to help facilitate conversations with Hamas about the return of American hostages. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken will visit Israel later this week. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. seeking stronger ties with Uganda as he welcomes the appointment of Envoy Betty Oyela Bigombe, the African country's new non-resident ambassador to the Philippines. Marcos hopes both countries will find ways to enhance their economic relationship. The Philippines' primary imports from Uganda include essential oils, resins, perfume, cosmetics, and toiletry preparations, among others. While the country primarily exports electrical machinery and equipment, parts, plastics, and other made-up textile articles. There are an estimated 96 Filipino nationals in Uganda as of last year, with remittances amounting to $850,000 for 2022. Now, Marcos also extending a warm welcome to Sri Lanka's new envoy to the Philippines, Chanaka Harsha Talpahewa, who pledged to elevate the South Asian country's relationship with the Philippines to a, quote, next level. In 2022, Sri Lanka ranked as the Philippines' 75th trading partner, with total trade reaching $29.29 million. Among the Philippines' top exports to Sri Lanka, cereal preparations, flour, starch or milk, chemical products, animal or vegetable fats, and oils, as well as paper. There are some 677 Filipinos in Sri Lanka as of 2022, most of them working as craft and related trade professionals, managers, plant and machine operators, as well as assemblers professionals, with OFW remittances from there reaching $760,000 for 2022. The country's leading carriers ramping up efforts to meet increasing air travel demand. Flag carrier Philippine Airlines will be jump-starting the holiday season with a resumption of more domestic routes. Starting December 15, PAL will operate daily flights between Cebu and General Santos City in South Cotabato. On the same day, it will relaunch daily flights between Cebu and Legazpi in Albay Province. A day later, on December 16, PAL will resume regular thrice-weekly flights between Cebu and Ozamis in Misamis Occidental. Meanwhile, Cebu Pacific boosting its capacity for international flights. The budget carrier says it's increasing its international capacity by a whopping 63% of its pre-pandemic level by flying over 700,000 more passengers by the end of this year. It currently flies to 25 international destinations with the latest addition of the Da Nang Vietnam route. The airline is also holding a seat sale until October 15, which allows passengers to book their flights for as low as 88 pesos exclusive of other fees. Now, the Philippine Agriculture Department is thinking of importing pork amid a possible shortage of the meat in time for the holiday season. The agency is projecting a 10-day supply shortfall in the fourth quarter as cases of African swine fever rise. At least 19 provinces in the country have recorded cases of ASF. The DA is also checking the need to impose a suggested retail price for pork if they observe price manipulation. Based on the DA's monitoring, in Metro Manila markets, pork prices range from 260 pesos to 400 pesos per kilo. Meanwhile, agricultural group SINAG not keen on the government's importation plan, citing ample supply of pork in cold storages across the country. Other importers also saying even if one imports today, the order won't arrive until January next year.
Kapag kukulangin tayo ng local na pork, tataas nila ang presyo ng local pork. Kapag tumaas ang presyo ng local pork, hihina ang consumption. And then the market, either lilipat sila sa imported o kung ayaw pa nila sa imported, lilipat sila sa local na manok o hindi muna sila kakain ng baboy.
Metrobank staying upbeat despite global headwinds, including the recent eruption of violence in the Middle East. SEVP Fernand Antonio Tancinco sees economic resilience, adding these challenges are presenting opportunities to invest.
The Asian financial crisis, global financial crisis, and recently the pandemic. And one thing that we have to really remember is we have to bet on sanity. Despite all the headwinds during the Asian financial crisis and even during the pandemic, when things seem to be collapsing, there's always a silver lining. And there's, I think that we have resiliency as a world and as an economy, but also as Filipinos to withstand these headwinds. These were opportunities to actually enter into markets. If you picked up, let's say, stocks during the height of the pandemic, then you would have increased it 50%, right? So bet on sanity.
Global messaging app Viber aims to help MSMEs scale up with its new offering. And as Jackie Pascual tells us, Viber's looking to finally launch Viber Pay by next year. Take a look.
Messaging app Viber launched its business account for small businesses in the Philippines. Viber earlier made the service available for large companies, and now it wants to expand its reach to small and medium enterprises or SMEs, which comprise majority of businesses in the country.
Our aim is to help these businesses to grow, a micro business to become a small business to become a medium business, and why not a medium business become a large business.
SMEs or anyone who wants to sell goods can open a business account on the app where they can showcase their products and services. Customers can search for the store and message the shop for orders or inquiries. In the future, Viber said it plans to roll out other services such as possible partnerships with logistics companies and add the in-app payment feature Viber Pay, which may be launched in the Philippines next year.
Make sure that it's the right time to launch with the right product fit for the users and the market itself. You can see the synergy. It's very clear that Viber Pay will be part of the benefits for this whole ecosystem.
At the recent opening of the Cybersecurity Month, some experts warn of potential scams in online shopping, with fraudsters victimizing customers or the business itself.
Cybercrime that we're facing for businesses. And this is whether you're a multinational company, a big, large enterprise here in the Philippines, and even the small to medium enterprises.
They try to ride the monthly promo cycles of Lazada, Shopee, Amazon even. No? You have the upcoming 10-10. No? After that, it's 11-11, 12-12. We see fraud to tend to scale up.
But Viber assured the public that the platform is secure.
We have our built-in algorithm to ensure that those numbers that can be of spam nature or scam nature, we will do the necessary to block. Second things, we are also checking against the companies. For example, they can't fake another established company by the account.
Viber says it has a 71% market share in the Philippines, one of its largest markets globally, and it is confident of staying on top in the country. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.